exploded. What did you do?
It was a minor miscalculation. I've already corrected it for future experiments.
This is why people have a problem with your college, Nelikon.
I don't deal with any college applicants these days, so don't bother asking.
The mages don't let us go in the college. They said it's not safe in there.
If there's anything you need, just let me know. I'm afraid there's not much to be said. Winterhold is hardly what it used to be. You can talk to Birna if you need to buy anything. She doesn't have much, but could certainly use the coin. And then there's our little inn. Most of the business we get is from folks here to visit the college. Though even that's dried up some. That's right. College of Winterhold, just north of town. Hard to miss. The mages are up in the college. You can ask them if they'll let you in. Then again, Nelikar might know. He's an old-timer from the college, but he has a room here. Here. Take a look at this. Some of the Jarl's men came by and left this bounty letter. Sure thing. It's yours for a day. I'll show you to your room. Right this way.
Aster says his paw says the college makes lots of bad things happen. But the mages I've seen look nice.
Let me know if there's anything else you need.
Yes.
The mages don't let us go in the college. They said it's not safe.
Oh yes, quite fine. My accommodation's here.
I trust you're not planning any trouble. What can I do for you, friend?
What's your business here in Winterhold? Should have known. Not that it matters anymore. No one bothers coming to Winterhold for any other reason. What's there to tell? It's mostly gone now, thanks to those damn mages in the college. Someday there'll be proof they caused the great collapse. Most of a city just dropping off into the sea. That doesn't just happen. I do. And if you count yourself among their numbers, then you've blood on your hands as well. There's nothing left of Winterhold. Nothing. Everyone knows it's the college's fault that the sea swallowed our city. Still, they deny it. But we all know the truth. Winterhold has lost much of its history, and with that, much of its power. I aim to change that. I've heard rumors of the resting place of the Helm of Winterhold. The very same helm that Jarl Hansa wore in the First Era. Hansa was in line to be High King of Skyrim, you know. Having that might get the ear of the other holds, and give me some authority. Good. I'll have a sum of gold waiting for your return. Until next time.
My job is to serve the Jarl, not wait. I don't really know anyone at the college. I guess everyone just...
You're someone who can get things.
Welcome to... We've got small weapons as well as big. Take a look. Take a look. Good doing business with you.
Divine smile on you, friend. I am an apprentice wizard, not a pack mule. Oh, very well, but make it quick. Lead on. What do you need? I am an apprentice wizard, not a pack mule. Oh, very well, but make it quick. Let's get going then. The smell of dank earth and worm-eaten wood is gonna make me lose my last meal. looks like this all over Skyrim.
lost.
But, you know, Winterhold used to be the seat of power in Skyrim. Now it's a shell. Can you believe that this hold used to contend for the throne of the High King? Now, perhaps others will listen. Here, your reward is promised. You have Winterhold's thanks. There is room in my court for a new Thane. It's an honorary title, mainly. But there are a few perks someone like you could make use of. However, I could only grant the title to someone who is known throughout my hold. You help my people. I'll make you my Thane. Good luck to you. All right, then.
Ours is the only family left that truly cares what happens to Winterhold.
Next in... Damn faithless Imperials. My job is to serve the Jarl, not waste time talking with travelers. Me? Nothing. And I hope to keep it that way. The Jarl is convinced I have some connection with the college, so he goes easy on me. Maybe you'd like to help me keep up appearances. Old Nelikar has a mage's staff in his room in the Frozen Hearth. It'd be good to have that staff, in case the Jarl starts wondering if I actually have a real connection to the college. Thanks. I'll be waiting for it. Mm-hmm. I don't really know anyone at the college. I guess everyone just assumes I do because I'm a Dunmer.
Mages don't let us go in the college. They said it's not safe in there. Aster says his paw says the college makes lots of bad things happen.
What do you think you're doing?
Mages don't seem look nice.
I don't deal with any college.
You have committed crimes against Skyrim and her people.
What say you in your defense?
Everything here appears to be in order. You can move along now.
Can I help you?
My job is to serve the Jarl, not waste time talking with travelers. This should come in handy. Here, let me show you a few tricks I've learned about buttering up royalty.
Safe travels.
Wait, I know you.
Can I help you with anything else? Till next time.
I'm just trying to have a quiet drink here, all right?
Ranmir beg a drink from you yet? That's gold wasted, friend. He owes this tavern enough coin to burn it down, build it back up, then burn it down again just for laughs. He's had some troubles in his life, but I can't have him drinking here without at least paying back some of the coin he owes. Go right ahead. He just might be sober enough to listen to you. It's not much, but we get by. Very little money passes through Winterhold anymore. But if there's one thing you can count on, it's folks needing a drink now and then. You mean the inn or Winterhold? Suppose it's the same answer either way. Winterhold's fallen on hard times, to say the least. Most folk packed up and left years ago. A few of us are either too stubborn or too crazy to go, so we do our best to make a living. Until next time.
It's not like there's anything to do here but drink anyway. Who are you to say what I should do? I'll pay her back when I'm ready. You're right. What would my forefathers think if they knew I wasn't paying my debts? Tell Haran I'll bring her the gold I owe.
Just say the word if you need a drink or something to eat. Thank you. He's not a bad man, just bad with his coins and his drink. My husband Dagger could tell you stories there. I have a couple of Ranmir's things that he traded to us back when he was still paying regularly. I say you've earned them. See ya.
If there's anything you need, just let me know.
Let's sate that appetite, huh? Well, not exactly. Listen, we're friends, right? I wonder if I could ask a favor of you. It's about Ranmir. Don't get me wrong. I don't have a problem with him being here all the time. He mostly keeps to himself, and so far he's been able to pay. I just hate to see what's happened to him. He hasn't always been like this, you know. Drunk, I mean. Well, he was a different person. Happy, outgoing, like anyone who's in love. See, Ranmir was involved with a pretty young woman named Isabel Rolaine. The two of them were very happy together, I thought. One day, she just disappeared. Ranmir was convinced she'd run off with someone else, leaving him behind. He turned to drinking, and what's left of him is what you see here every day. I'm not sure. I hope that maybe if she could be found, if he had some sort of explanation, that maybe he could put himself back together. I'm in no position to go searching for her, but perhaps you could.
Unless you're bringing me another round, you can just keep walking. What? Don't you say that name to me. Don't you dare, ever. Yeah.
Can I help you with anything else?
Now here's a man I'm glad to see. Oh no. Dagger's been talking at you, hasn't he? Gotten you roped into his little plan to fix Ranmir's life. I'll tell you what I told him. Stay out of it. It's none of your business. Those aren't folks you want to get tangled up with. You'll wind up getting yourself killed. Dagger shouldn't have said a word about it. I love the man, bless his heart, but he doesn't know the whole story. One night, Ranmir was in here like always, drinking himself to death. When I told him there was no more haunting brew, that he drank all of it, he got angry. He ranted at me, how I didn't know what he's been through, how Isabel broke his heart when she ran off with some thief named Vex. He said he'd even gone to Riften to try and find the bastard. I think maybe he was hoping they'd just kill him, and that'd be the end of it. Dagger never heard any of this, and I chose to keep it to myself. I'm only telling you so you don't get into trouble. Riften and thieves means trouble. Just leave it alone. No, there isn't, and I suggest you leave it at that. I don't want to see anyone get hurt over this.
pull up a seat. Have a drink.
Ready for some work, or are you just gonna wander around all day? Who's asking? Not him again. He came nosing around Riften a while back, making a lot of noise about me. He was persuaded to leave before he found me. Funny. I'd have thought she would have gone back to him by now. She came through a while ago, wanted to know where she could get her hands on something valuable. Anything, really. I told her it was a bad idea, that she wasn't cut out for what'd be necessary, but she wouldn't hear it. So, I gave her some advice, pointed her towards Hobbs Fall Cave, and that was that. You think you're finished? I've got plenty more where that came from.
Pull up a seat. Have a drink.
I guess I have a minute.
Gods watch over your battles, friend.
Unless you're bringing me another round, you can...
If there's anything you need, just let me know.
The mages don't let us go in the college.
I'm just trying to have a quiet drink here, all right? Unless it's gold for another round of drinks, I don't want to hear it. A what? Don't you go pulling my leg. Give it here. This is really from her, isn't it? Did she really run off and do this for me? By the Eight, she's dead, isn't she? And it's all my fault. I have some thinking to do. Thank you for this.
I'll say I do what's necessary so we can get by. Have to, since I can't count on my brother for anything. Wasn't by choice, I can tell you that. Options were in short supply. Ranmir and I grew up here, and nearly any money I make, he drinks away. Without the coin to pack up and leave, I decided to take to trading. Very funny. I'm sure you've noticed that Winterhold isn't exactly overflowing with people. So I'll sell whatever I can. If it's worth putting a price on, you can bet I'll do it. I've been burned a few times, made a few bad deals, but mostly I come out on top. Yeah, it was stupid of me. I shouldn't have believed the story and just refused the trade. But I didn't, and now I'm stuck with this worthless junk. Some line about this claw thing in Ingolbarrow. He said it was worth more than its weight in gold if I took it back there. Something about placing it back in Ingol's chamber, I don't know. What was I thinking? Even if it were true, I'm not setting foot in some ancient tomb filled with who knows what. I don't even care anymore. You want to check it out? Fine. I'll sell you the thing for 50 gold, and then it's your problem. Fine, here you go. You get killed on account of this thing? It's not my fault. Got it? But I suppose if it does actually turn out to be worth something, let me know, will you? Aye.